Hello, I'm Daniele, a member of the Aldryn development team here at Divio. One of Aldryn's most important features is the way it allows you to deploy your own Django code while providing you with a comfortable and familiar local environment for development. This tutorial will show you how to set up that environment and get an Aldryn site running on your own computer. The Aldryn online documentation contains a how-to guide covering the same material as this tutorial. On Aldryn, code runs in a fairly standard Django environment, which means that just about any Django code can be deployed to Aldryn. It does, however, have some specific requirements. In order to be sure that your code will run as expected on our cloud-based servers, the local environment it provides replicates, as far as possible, the one your code will encounter when deployed. This is the Aldryn project, called Local Development, that we're going to get up and running locally. It's a new project based on our standard site. We'll need the Aldryn command line client installed. It's on PyPI and can be installed in the usual way using pip. Now we log into our Aldryn account using the Aldryn login command. We need to replicate our Aldryn project in a local workspace using Aldryn workspace create. It'll take a few minutes to download and install all the dependencies. What we see unfolding in our terminal is just what happens on the Aldryn server when we create a new project there. The local development directory that has just been created contains three further directories. There's the hidden directory .site, our Django project, complete with manage.py, settings, site static files, and so on. There's .virtualenv, also hidden, the Python virtual environment for the project. And there's a directory called dev, a working directory for our convenience while developing, that has been placed on the Python path. Aldryn uses Postgres, so we will need a PostgreSQL server running locally too. Setting this up is beyond the scope of this tutorial, but there's plenty of help online. The Manage Project section of the Aldryn Control Panel offers options for downloading and restoring databases. We need to create a new backup of our site. A few moments later, we can refresh the page and download the backup we've just created. We need to unzip and untar the file that has been downloaded. This contains the database, media files, and more. We import the database.dump file into a new database. You'll need an appropriate PostgreSQL client for your system for that. We're also going to need to adjust the settings for the local version of the project so that it can use our local database. Rather than making changes to settings.py, which would be overwritten next time we synchronize the local site with Aldryn, we'll override the database URL setting by creating an environment variable. We create a file, .env, in the root of the project directory, containing the correct database URL. Now we're ready to activate this new virtualenv and fire up the Django run server. Our Aldryn site is now running on localhost on port 8000. We've now replicated the Aldryn project locally. It's the ideal environment in which to carry out development work for deployment on Aldryn. In the next tutorial, we'll create a small application in the local environment before deploying it to Aldryn.